Primal with a purpose. That's how a Sac State grad describes his sport. Javelin comes from ancient times, where Chris Kirkwood faces the very modern challenge of making the Olympic team.
Nice.
No matter how hard Chris Kirkwood works a client at his fitness ranger's gym.
Not out of breath already, come on.
He will always work himself harder, longer, and hopefully farther. The Sac State grad holds the record at Hornet Stadium in javelin, is currently ranked 15th in the country, and is heading to the U.S. Olympic track and field trials.
24 of us will go for the trials, and then out of that, the top two will go to the Olympics.
Not bad for a guy who started his college sports career as a football player.
So I saw javelin, and I was like, well, I could throw a football pretty far. I'm a good baseball player. So I picked it up, and I went from 156 now to 230 feet.
A men's javelin is 8 feet long. It only weighs about a pound and a half, which doesn't seem like that big of a deal to throw until you try it. This sport is deceptively difficult.
It's kind of like a car crash.
Proper javelin technique is so physically demanding that he can only do a full-on throw 5 or 6 times per day. The rest of the time, he's drilling body and brain.
Every day, you just got to keep a little reminding yourself, and you're like, okay, I do have a legitimate chance.
A chance at a childhood dream accomplished one throw at a time. And go to facebook.com/KCRADeirdre, and it will take you to a slideshow of our shoot with Chris. That's in Deirdre's diary, that is on Facebook, where you'll find that. And then also tell you about Deirdre's diary. We spent the morning yesterday with 1968 gold medalist Debbie Meyer. She's out teaching high school kids how they can do their best in the pool. If you go to the blog today, you can read a story about that swimsuit that she wore in the 1968 games. It's kind of funny. And the 2012 USA Swimming Grand Prix is underway this weekend in Santa Clara. The International Swim Meet is the last chance for American swimmers to qualify for the U.S. Olympic swimming trials at the end of this month. Look for the 100 backstroke featuring Natalie Coughlin from Northern California and Australian Emily Seebohm to be the big event over the weekend. And keep your Olympic story ideas coming. You can email me at dfitzpatrick@hearst.com or just drop me a line on Facebook. And again, you'll find me at facebook.com/KCRADeirdre. Coming up next week, do you think you have a shot at going to the Olympics? I have proof now that I do not. We are trying some of the lesser known events, everything from archery to Teo in table tennis. That's entertaining. And it's
who knew?
Coming up next week here on KCRA 3.